when it comes to whether assistance, donor money has been useful for Pakistan's purposes or not, I think the answer is an overwhelming no. And the reason for that is that the recipient country, Pakistan being one of them, has little or no control on the quality. You may want higher quantity, but on the quality of assistance that comes. And as you know, Nadeem, very, very well, donor assistance, we like to call it donor assistance, this is a euphemism, right? But it's in all types of categories. There are some very expensive loans, there are some not so expensive loans, and there's some grant assistance. And we tend to believe that anything that is coming in grant assistance is free money, and we must be able to utilize it, according to the whatever the donors want. And because the donor system is always more well-fed and more efficient in some ways, efficient in being able to get the resources. So your system actually suffers. So instead of empowering the system, the donor money actually disempowers it and makes it less efficient, the system, as in the Pakistani government system. Now, this is, we can go in as much detail as you want, but let me give you the broad brush picture from what I have seen. As you know, for 7 years, I tried to work very hard on trying to get a bit of an aid assistance reform in Pakistan. The entire aid architecture is, first of all, governed by authorities which do not sit in Pakistan. Okay, so the congressman in the US, the parliament in the UK, the party in China, etc., will all determine where and how much aid goes into Pakistan. Now, it's a terrible place for any country to be, an aid-dependent country. And I genuinely believe that in terms of money, we are not as aid dependent as we are in terms of our mental dependence on aid. We are, of course, needing IMF assistance, because of our balance of payment crisis emerging every now and then, and some balance of payment support from the World Bank and ADB, again, to look at crisis modes. But all of this project assistance that comes into Pakistan has actually done more damage because it has always built parallel universes. And the biggest crying example of that is what has happened to the energy sector. I think our energy sector back in the 60s and 70s was a pretty decent one. I mean, people tell you stories about the World Bank people coming in, wanting to learn from our VAPTA people.